closing the gap of 165 slightly, but work to be done. They're going to have to fire away here in this third and final game in order to try and finish strong and win the all-important fourth game and get out of this hole they dug in that first game of the day. Coach is making some adjustments over here. You see the teams are actually looking off to the left here, applauding some of the JV bowlers who are rolling really well next door here. I'm wondering if the coaches are pausing here to, one, make adjustments, but two, maybe change their lineup. Pennridge bowlers looking around. Looks like they're definitely going to make a lineup change. There you go. There you see the bowler coming over from the JV lanes. They're definitely going to make a switch here. And we'll see what happens here as we start the third game. So, ladies and gentlemen, here we are back at Fasenda Whitaker for this third and final game of the Pennridge versus Norristown Area High School boys bowling match. This third and crucial game is going to be very, very important, again, for total pins. Every bowling match is made up of four total games. They bowl three total, and then the fourth game is actually an accumulation of total pins. Right now, it looks like Pennridge, still after that huge first game where they put up over 1,000 pins, is up slightly. Norristown taking a chunk out of that lead in the second game, winning by about 48 pins. But with work to do here in this last game, they're going to have to put up a performance that is very, very strong against this Pennridge team. As I mentioned earlier, Pennridge did make a switch. They're going to bring over John Succi from the other lanes. He's going to roll in the second position here, hoping to give them a spark to hold on to this 117-pin lead. Now, 117 pins may seem like a lot, but with these varsity bowlers, 117 pins can be made up pretty quickly. Most of these kids are averaging well over 150 to 160 pins consistently. Some of these bowlers are averaging over 200. So a big game here on either side can definitely sway this in Norristown's favor or can end in their demise. Over on lane 31, there's Andre starting off with a 7. That first ball looked a little bit more inside than he had been playing all day. I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but again, every single frame, every single shot is an adjustment. Over on lane 32, that is Peter Herzberger. He too rolled a 7, getting a little bit light on the 3-pin over there. Andre dropping off into the gutter. That's going to be an open for him, an early open. Hopefully he can bounce back in the next two or three frames, try and clear up that open as fast as possible. Over on lane 32, there's Peter covering over, intentionally going across the head pin, I think, there to take out the 2 and also the 7, picking up his spare. Every pin is going to count in this game. Over on lane 31, that's Sam Rosenberg playing a little bit more inside. It seems that most of the bowlers, the first two bowlers here at Norristown, have gone inside over that third arrow, between the third and the second arrow, the 10 and 15 board. Meanwhile, over on lane 32, Pennridge seems to be playing a little bit more outside, around that 5 board. In case you're wondering how I'm figuring out those boards, every arrow working from right to left is 5 boards. So the first arrow is a 5 board, the second arrow is a 10, so on and so forth. Over on lane 31, Sam trying to swing outside. To clip across a 5, almost gets there. That was a good effort on that big split. So Norristown starting out game 3 here with 2 opens. Over on 32, that one drops off into the gutter for John Succi on his first frame over here on the varsity lanes. He's going to have to make a very quick adjustment. which is very, very difficult. I've been there before. Greg Sontag trying to ease up on a shot. Gets into the pocket. Light roll off the wall. Gets a strike. Norristown needed that one. Hopefully that gets Mike and Dylan to fire here as well. Again, that third position, very, very important, being that spark plug in the middle of the lineup. Jason Ewan going across the head pin. Gets a lucky break there. Chips out the 10 pin. Mike Berkowitz playing inside. Gets across the head pin with just enough power to drive the head pin off the wall and chip off the 10. That's two strikes in a row for Norristown. Going cross alley here. Jason Ewan picks up his spare with confidence as a six pin is clipped off there. A little pat on the back from Zach Valentine. He understands the importance of every single pin here. The pressure is squarely on Norristown to try and close this gap. However, if they can get off to an early start, they can definitely put that pressure square on Pennridge. There's Zach Valentine going through the head pin there. Getting an eight count, leaving himself a 6-10. Over on lane 31, the anchor of Norristown, Dylan Kopstick. He too fires between the second and third arrow, changing it up a little bit. Trips down the 10, trips down the 8. That is three strikes in a row for Norristown. And an open on 32 for Zach Valentine. Josh McNamara on 32, gets a little high on the head pin. That delivery looked a little different than he had in the first two games. Over on 31, Peter Herzberg getting way inside. Seems that a lot of these bowlers have decided on lane 31 to play inside. We'll see what Norristown does on lane 32, if they too decide to play outside as Pennridge is. That's Josh McNamara trying to throw a backup ball. Gets to that 10 pin. Backup ball, simply meaning that he's right-handed, but the ball will curve to the right. Whereas those right-handers, ball curves to the left. Great effort there from Peter Herzberg trying to chip over the six to get that 4-7 on that split. That's another open for Pennridge. It's actually their fourth open already of this match. Over on lane 32, Andre playing outside. It seems as though everyone has decided to play outside on 32 and play inside on 31. And just as I say that, John Succi goes outside on 31, gets into the pocket. He's going to have to make all the adjustments as quickly as possible. He's going to have to rely quickly on his teammates to get a feel for these lanes and try and get rolling as quickly as possible to help Pennridge attempt to hold on to this 117-118 pin lead. Sam Rosenberg, an unfortunate second split of this early in this game. That's John Succi covering pins on lane 31. Breaking that open streak. That was three opens there over Pennridge up until that point. Meanwhile, Norristown, up until that split there for Sam, had thrown four strikes in a row. Sam now starting this match with two opens. They're going to need him to get hot at some point here to really try and solidify their efforts in getting into this match and trying to cover these pins. Greg Sontag playing a little outside, crosses over, doesn't get the head pin to drop the 10. Over on 31, Jason Ewing covering pins as he has been throughout the day. Going cross alley on these lanes right now is very, very difficult. To say that the oil pattern is patchy is an understatement. As Greg found out there, going cross alley, the ball jumped up just a little bit early, caught a dry spot. It bit in. Ball starts to curve. There's definitely challenge out here right now. Mike Burka was playing a little bit more inside there. On lane 32, gets a six count. Quickly up on lane 32 again, changes balls and fires right through, picks up that spare. Just gonna give Mike a 20 in the first frame. We'll see what he does back on lane 31, where he threw a strike in the first frame. Josh McNamara there expected a lot more out of that ball. It was in the pocket, just does not get the break. Looks like he left himself. A very difficult split. That looks like the 4-9 split. He's going to try and go in between these and take the 4 off the wall, have it come back for the 9, or he's going to try and shoot as if he's taking out the 7 pin and get the 4 to slide across. Meanwhile, on 32, a very nice ball. Easy, smooth delivery from Dylan. That is 2 strikes in a row. Josh McNamara opening up on that split. That's 2 open frames for him. On lane 32, Peter Herzberg trying to bounce back from his split. Andre on 31 trying to keep his mark streak going. Playing inside, a little high in the livery. Gets a close roll, gets a wobble on the 7. You see he wanted that one to fall. Spare on 32 for Peter. Andre going to go cross alley here. Lots of rotation. Ball's in the oil. It slides a lot further. Picks up that spare. It gives Andre a 27 in the second. Working on a spare. Let's see what Sam does here after 2 opens early in this match. Correction, in this game. Sam is capable of getting hot here. He has shot a 169 and a 180 so far today. Let's see if he can get on track here. Plays way inside. Going to go across the nose. Chips out the 10 pin. A spare here would be a good way to get rolling. These next couple frames right here in the middle of this game become very, very important. Spare over there on 32 for John Tsuchi. There's Sand going across the alley again. All the oil in the middle of that lane is going to make that ball slide a little bit further. Catch a little dry spot hopefully at the end and pick up the spare. That is the first mark for Sam in this game. It's a spare. He has a 18 in the second. We'll see what happens on lane 32 to get a total for him. A strike gets him up to a 38, though. Here's Greg playing inside also. Goes across the head pin, trips down that 10. That's an important strike for Greg. Greg seems to be striking on 31. Let's see if we can figure out 32. It's Jason Yung on 32, chopping off the 9. That's his first open of this game. Playing way outside. Zach Valentine gets a 7 count. He leaves the exact same spare that Jason Yoon left a second ago. Meanwhile, only 31 going across the head. Mike Berkowitz, that's a strike again on lane 31. That leaves Mike with a 40 in the second. Zach Valentine, you see the body language. Chopped that one off. Did not expect the ball to jump up that fast. At this point in the match, it is definitely mental. Here comes Dylan Kopsik over on 31. Snapping through that at the bottom. Gets in the pocket a little bit light. Gets the roll. That is a turkey for Dylan Kopsik. Three strikes are off this game. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go ahead and say it right now. The pressure is starting to switch here on the Pennridge. And as I say that, there's Josh McNamara putting one in the pocket on lane 32. That's a strike for him. At the end of three frames, this match is definitely getting tighter. Remember, it's not about this particular game. It's about the entire match to try and win. Total pins. Right now, Pennridge has won the first. Norristown won the second. But in total pins, there's a 9 there for Andre on lane 32. In total pins, Pennridge still holds that slight lead. At the end of three frames, Norristown has 11 marks, most of which being strikes, so it's definitely going to help. Whereas Pennridge only has eight marks, either a strike or a spare through the first three frames. I remember my old bowling coach telling me you could always tell who's inching away by the number of marks or an open frame. So Norris has a 3-mark lead right now, which helps out. But they're going to have to string together some strikes and some spares here to try and really cut into that lead. Over on 32, Sam gets into the pocket, striking down there on 32. That's going to give him a 38 in the third. Sontag goes across the head pin just a little too far, leaving himself with a 1-3-6 with a spare. Jason Young striking on lane 31. Pennridge seems to be trying to get back in the groove here. In this fourth frame, trying to get that pressure off of them. Meanwhile, Greg Sontag keeping the pressure on with that spare. Every strike, every spare is going to count right now. Zach Valentine leaving a ringing 10-pin there. It looked like he is trying to find the rhythm here on these lanes. They have definitely broken down. Mike Berkowitz over on 32, crosses a head pin, leaves himself a 5-10 split. That's one major risk of playing across a head pin like that. You always leave that 5 hanging out in there, that 10 pin. If the head pin doesn't get to it, it will stand. Josh McNamara trying to pick up his teammate there, keep him firing. He knows every pin counts here. Mike goes outside. Oh, just sneaks by on the outside there, leaving his first open. His first open of this game. And that does break Norristown's mark streak. That was 10 marks in a row up to that point. Josh McNamara picking up his teammate, firing a strike on lane 31. Let's see what Dylan can keep his streak going. He has 3 strikes in a row coming up on 32. Snaps to the bottom, plays outside. Gets into the pocket a little bit heavy. Leaves himself a 6-pin. Andre back up on 31. Into the pocket, a little bit high as well. Gets the break. Covering pins over on lane 32 is Dylan. With that spare, Dylan's going to have a 30 in the first. Excuse me, a 59 in the second. And a 79 in the third. With a he'll wait for his first ball on lane 31 to see what totals in the fourth. Rosberg playing a little bit outside of his line that he had been playing. The ball slides through the oil. Yeah, you see him shaking his head. He knew that one got away from him just a little bit. Over on 32, a ball slides inside. 10-pin stands. That's open frame for Peter Herzberg. That's going to give him a 71 in the fifth. Meanwhile, on 31, Sam leaves a 5-pin standing. We're approaching that 6th frame, right in the middle of the game here. Sometimes in bowling, we get a chance to kind of reset here in the middle of this game. You have five frames left. That 10th frame, we can pick up a couple extra shots with strikes early. So if you get hot here in this 5th, 6th frame, you do a lot of damage quickly in these. This team format and trying to game pins. Greg on lane 31 leaves himself the 1-2-4, it looks like there. 1-2-8 to pick up. He's going to go cross alley here. Sorry, cross the head pin there and drive all that back into the pit. In this game, Greg's in a picture of consistency. His shot looks really, really good. He's picking up and covering pins in that third position. As I mentioned before, that is a spark plug to the team. Just keeping everything rolling as Mike comes up here on lane 31. He's across the head pin. Mike trying to cover these pins, get that spare, get away from that. That open split he had on lane 32. He's going to try and make some adjustments, I'm sure, on 32 to remedy that situation. Jason Jung knocking down his spare on lane 32. Mike covering his spare on lane 31. Norristown is doing a very good job of covering pins. I'm sure Coach Johnson reminded them at the beginning of this game, just keep covering pins. Keep the pressure on Pennridge and see what happens. There's a strike for Zach Valentine. You see him throw his hands in the air. He finally got the break he wanted. That is his first strike of this game. After shooting a 247 in the first and a 195 in the second game. Pockets, but not getting the break is Josh McNamara. Going cross alley here. Lots of rotation as usual. Bang, knocking on that 10 pin. That's going to give Dylan a 98 in the fourth. More speed here from Peter on the outside. That ball is not break back up. And with these lane conditions, this spare might actually be a little bit trickier than it looks. Gets the five, does not get the spare. That's back-to-back opens for Peter Herzberg. Andre opening up in lane 32. Peter Herzberger started this match out with a 226 and a 161. John Tsuchi in the pocket gets that strike to fall. Playing way outside is Sam. And that does not run back up for him. It goes through the three pin. Leaving himself the 1-2-4-8. Sam has two options here. Either throw a strike ball and try and get the head pin to do all the work, or go across the head pin. He goes across the head pin. Picks up the spare. 66 after the open in the fifth. We'll have to see what he does here in the sixth. Greg Sontag, nice easy delivery. A little high on the head pin. Leaves us with a 4-7 for the spare. Zach Valentine firing across the lane there, trying to swing it through the oil and get it to come back to the pocket. Doesn't get a 10-pin to fall. Again, there's a nice easy delivery one more time from Greg. Covers his spare. Mike gets the head pin and trip down the seven. That's a strike from Mike Berkowitz here in the sixth. Mike today has fired a 171 and a 219. He's on pace here to those number of strikes in a row, he can actually get up over 200 again. Dillon playing a little further outside. Gets into the pocket light, leaves himself a 5-7 split. I think maybe he deserved a little better than that, but that's part of bowling. Josh McNamara dropping off into the gutter there on that 10-pin, giving him an open frame. It gives him an 85 in the fifth and 94 in the sixth. Dillon gets just a little too much of the five. Can't trip over to the seven. That's his first open. Loft gets it out there, gets a strike in the seventh. Trying to match 132 is Peter Herzberger, and he does. That is a strike for him as well. Sam's going to try and follow up Andre's lead here. Swings through the oil, gets into the pocket, trips it down. Big smile there. That's back-to-back strikes for Norristown. In the seventh frame, John Tsuchi coming up on lane 32, I believe. He's going to try and keep pace here as well. Just outside the pocket. Up ball. He got stuck a little bit, got a little more loft than I've seen him throw today. Played way outside. Gets it across the head pin. He too throws a strike here toward the seventh frame. Nice smooth delivery there. One more time from Greg. Covering his spare. That gives him a 99 in the sixth. Jason Jung in the pocket. Made a little bit high. Unfortunate break there. He's left himself a pretty large split. The 4-6-7-10. Many options of picking this one up. Let's see who's most comfortable with. Mike pulls up all way inside. Misses Mark clearly. Leaving himself a... large spare, but doable spare. If he gets a strike ball into the pocket, it will work itself out. That three count. Again, he's inside. And there is that aforementioned five pin, that risk you always take when you go across the head pin. Zach Valentine on that ball did not look like he was happy with it, but as bowling would go, all the pins go down. That is one of the pieces of bowling. You could throw a perfect shot and the pin will stand. Sometimes you get away with one. I've been there before. Most definitely at this point of the match, a very, very mental sport. Over 2.5 games in, what has turned out to be a very tight match. Norristown battling back after that first game. Pennridge trying to hold on to their lead. Most definitely this is a mentally fatiguing game here in the third. They're trying to keep it all together. Over on 31, Dylan into the pocket. Speaking of keeping it together, after an open in the sixth, that's a strike in the seventh for Dylan. Going across the head pin on 32 is Josh McNamara. He opened also in the sixth. He's going to try and pick up his spare. Just looking at the marks, it looks like Norristown still has a slight lead in this game, but they're going to have to really turn on the pressure here. Pin slides, pin stands. You'd be shocked how often that actually does happen. Spare on 32. For Josh McNamara, coming up on 32 is going to be Andre Harper. He's going to try and build on his strike in the seventh. Gets an 8 count there. With his spare, he would go to a 103 in the 7th. Just John Succi over on 31. That one slipped and got away from him. I mentioned earlier on 32 that the ball looked like it wasn't the same delivery. That same thing there. That one got away from him. It drops off into the gutter. He does have the opportunity of the spare. But with that... on that gutter ball, that's going to leave him with a 104 in the six, and we'll see what happens on the second ball here to get a total for him in the seventh. Again, that loft out to the marks gets an 8 count. That's going to give him a 122 in the seventh and a total of 130 in the eighth. Meanwhile, Sam Rosenberg has found his line. He is pounding away. That's two strikes in a row for him. Greg going across the head pin. Gets the 8 count. Jason Jung trying to keep his team in this game. With a strike there in the 8th, bouncing back from his open frame after that very difficult 4-7-6-10 split on 32. Smooth delivery from Greg. Gets a little bit high. Taps the 3. Does not get it to lean all the way over. There's Zach Valentine swinging through the oil one more time. Perhaps that break over on 32 has got him back in the zone. That'll be great for Pennridge, not so great for Norristown. But there is a strike again from Mike Berkowitz after that open in the seventh. Mike had a 114. And here's a great part about bowling. If Mike can strike out, he can actually still shoot a 204. Something happening there on 31. I don't know if there's a lane courtesy there or he got stuck. The grip didn't feel right. He pulled up before releasing that ball. But on 32, there's no problem. Dylan Kopsik striking down one more time. That open frame in the six is it's long in the pass for him. Two strikes in a row, really pushing his team here to the end. Josh McNamara, thankfully, didn't throw that first ball. Striking here in the eighth, giving him a 114 in the seventh. Big backswing. Had a Peter Herzberger there on lane 32. Maybe try to get a little more power, try and straighten that ball out. Gets a nine count. Andre way inside, lots of power. Leaving himself the 136 for the spare. Inside on lane 32 is Peter Herzberger. That's an open for him. We are coming down to the wire here, and this has gotten very, very close. Norristown has fired back these last two games. They have crept themselves, if my math is correct, they have crept themselves right into this total pins conversation. This is going to be a very tight ninth and tenth frame. Nothing's decided here just yet. That ball's going to go across the head pin, leaving John Succi with a very difficult 1-5-10 pickup. Meanwhile, over on 31, Sam playing a lot more inside than he had been on 31. Gets his third strike in a row. That's a turkey for him. That's the second turkey of this game for Norristown. One earlier to start the match with Dylan Kopsik. John Succi goes across the head pin. The second open here in ninth frame for Pennridge. Greg Sontag striking on 31. Norristown is building on their marks lead here in the third game. And also building a nice solid foundation going into that 10th frame. It's critical, this ninth frame. Jason Young swinging through the oil. Gets across the head pin, gets the break. Mike Berkowitz, he strikes on 31. The pace is quickened here. It is clear to these bowlers that this match is close, and they are all firing all cylinders now. Zach Valentine trying to repeat on 32. Another strike, that's his turkey for the day, or for this game. That is his third strike in a row. In the ninth frame, that is two marks for Pennridge. And two open frames. Striking again on 32, it's Pennridge, it's Josh McNamara. Dylan's up cross alley. Lots of rotation. And knocks that one down. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we go, 10th frame. It all comes down to this. This match is very, very close. Every single one of these shots is going to count. Andre on 32. The split here, he's going to try and go in between the 3 and the 10, or try and tap the outside, the inside of the 3, and drive it into the 10. He's going to have to try and make the spare now with Peter Herzenberger covering over on 31. Kicks it over, gets the split to drop. With a strike, Andre can shoot a 158. With a strike, Peter Herzberger will shoot a 148. There's his strike. He will shoot a 148. Andre, with that 7 count, is going to shoot a 155. He's been very consistent today, shooting a 159, a 161, and a 155 in that leadoff roll. It's one of the most important things you can ask for. I'm sure Coach Johnson is always asking for our bowlers to be consistent. However, that leadoff position, very, very important that you're consistent in that spot. And Andre certainly was today. Over on 31, John Tsuchi finding the pocket, dropping every pin for a strike. Sam Rosenberg, who is firing all cylinders, the back half of this game, gets another strike over on 32 to build on his strike count. And I apologize, he actually had a turkey after that third strike in the ninth frame. That's his fourth strike in a row. John Tsuchi leaves himself a very tough split over there on 31. A little outside on 32 for Sam. Doesn't get that fifth strike. You can see he wanted that one really bad. He's going to have to go across alley here, try and tap on that 10 pin. With a spare, Sam would shoot a 195 to go along with his 169 and his 180 on the day. Tsuchi going for it. Great effort. Doesn't get at the fall. That's going to be a 156 for John Tsuchi. Sam does not get the slide through the oil far enough. That's going to give him a 194 for the day. Over on 31, Jason Yoon, that got into the pocket. It's looked a little bit soft on the rotation. Doesn't get the mix. And he leaves himself with a 479. Tough time for a split. This 10th frame is a highly contested match. He too tries to slide it over, gets there very close, but does not get it to go. There's no good time for an open frame, but the 10th frame is a very tough time for an open. 10th frame, the only frame in which you can get 3 balls to be thrown. That's a tough moment there for Pennridge. This match has got a little bit closer, especially with Greg picking up his spare. Can he put the pressure squarely again on Pennridge? A strike here for Greg gives him a 166 to go along with his 149, a 126 in the second game. It's across the headpin, gets him to fall. That will be the 166 for Greg. That is his highest game of the day, and a great time for it. His team needed him, and he was very consistent through this third game, bouncing back from that 126, as well as Sam with that 194, just really being a spark plug and strong in the middle of this team to keep them going on this strike right there for Mike Berkowitz. And it's 3 in a row for him. That's actually his 6th strike of this game. Mike goes across the head pin, pounds down the 10 pin. Seven strikes in this game. One more will give him a 204 for the game to go along with his 171 and 219. Over on 31, Josh McNamara, see the body language. He knew he wanted a strike there in the pocket. Mike Berkowitz firing down one more time. It's another strike. With those two open frames, three open frames so far here in the 10th frame, I have to say the door is definitely open for Norristown here to step on through and win this not only third game, but also win the match 3-1 after that big lead that Pennridge had out there in the first, after the first game. You see Zach Valentine motioning. He's going to wait and see what Dylan does here. He has a roller, gets a tap, doesn't get it to fall. That gives Dylan a 193 in the ninth frame. Josh McNamara in the pocket gets an 8 count. I think this with a 181 to go along with his 196 and his 189. Dylan going cross alley. Gets the spare. You see Dylan probably questioning, what do I need? What do I need? With a strike, Dylan will shoot a 213. If he gets in the pocket, Norristown wins this match. He needs 5 pins to win. In the pocket, a little bit high. He gets 7, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to do the quick math here. But I think Norristown may have just won this match by a total of a few pins. It's going to be close. They're looking up at the board right now. There's a view of our scoreboard here at the end of the third. 929 to 801. That's a great series for the Norristown, for the boys of Norristown, rallying back. Pennridge struggled in the beginning of that match, or beginning of that third game. Here are our totals. Andre Harper threw all the way to the end there. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure to bring this Norristown-Pennridge match to you. Norristown winning by 2 pins, averaging a 178.67, and Pennridge averaging a 178.53. Look forward to seeing you again on the lanes. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.